Voluptuously Skinny, and I'm here with my post-op week 35 update. I am actually 8 months as of the 16th of this month, and this is also my post-op update week, I think, 8 for my breast reduction surgery. So my high weight was 369.9, my surgery weight was 329.6, my current weight is 219.8 pounds, and that means weight gone this past week of 1.8 pounds since surgery, that's 109.8, and then altogether, I have lost 150.1 pounds. That is a whole entire adult. So, and I said I was going to change my wording. So I have gotten rid of 150.1 pounds. And last week I noticed that I said I had lost 146 pounds, but it was off. It should have been like 148 pounds, point something like that. But yeah, 150.1 pounds. So yeah. I'm ecstatic, even if I don't sound like it. It's late. It's about 11:30 this evening, Wednesday evening, and I've just gotten in for my son's graduation, which was amazing as well. I'm so excited for him. So, but anyway, total gone is 150.1 pounds, and I'm now 9.8 pounds away from my next mini goal. My average protein for this week has gone up. It was 72 grams. My average calories went up quite a bit. And this is the first time that my average calories has been over 1,000. And it was 1,117 calories. Yep. As far as activity is concerned, I am up and I'm at 'em. I'm really trying to get my daily routine back into effect, so that I won't be so exhausted when I go to work. I still get very exhausted. Excuse me. Even like now. But I'm trying to get back into the moving and grooving and shaking of things so that I can be prepared for work in the next week and a half. This week ate lots and lots and lots of carbs. This is typically the week that I have my PMS symptoms. And my son and I, we went to a popcorn shop and I bought popcorn. And I have been eating popcorn every single day, literally. Every single day, 2 to 4 cups of popcorn. And so I ended up getting rid of all the popcorn today. I didn't eat all of it, but I did eat some of it. And then the rest of it, I got rid of. I said, I've got to stop. So I will be on a hiatus from popcorn for a little while. I even ate chips. So I ate some hot Cheetos. I ate some kettle chips that a friend had brought over. So I will be on a hiatus from popcorn, definitely. Chips I can manage a little better. But the popcorn, I was getting crazy with it. It just gotta go. Gotta go. And just giving into my cravings. I think a lot of it had to deal with emotional eating, as far as, like I said, the PMS, the craving, but also with everything that's just been going on and it finally coming to a head and me just trying to work through it. My son's youngest son's birthday, my son's graduation, just wondering if they were going to total out my car, which they did not. So hopefully that will be fixed in the next week or two. And just feeling exhausted by the end of the day. So a lot of it was emotional eating. I will be contacting the nutritionist. I have an appointment with her next week. And so I will be contacting her or letting her know that I definitely need more information on emotional eating. And I will be talking to her about that. And as far as, you know, the sleeve definitely keeps me from eating way too much, and I'm so thankful for that. But even with the popcorn, that is a slider food, so I can eat more of that at one time than I can eat of anything else. And so the sleeve will definitely stop me from eating too much.
I'm so sorry, y'all.
It'll stop me from eating too much, but in a couple hours when that food is gone, I can definitely eat again. So, the other thing that I was doing was drinking through a straw. That gave me so much gas, way too much gas. So definitely won't be doing that. But I did that on a couple of days. And the first day I was just like, couldn't figure it out. Why was I having so much gas? And I was thinking that maybe, because I had a follow-up with my primary care, and I was thinking that maybe it was residual from the gallbladder or what have you. But it wasn't. When I got down to thinking about it, it was that straw, using that straw. And so I will not be doing that anymore. We'll be just using good old-fashioned sipping. So I've had no adverse reactions really to the gallbladder. A lot of people said that I would have diarrhea if I ate certain things, and I guess maybe I'm not eating those things that, like a lot of fatty foods, which the popcorn wasn't really fatty. It was mostly low fat type popcorn, but it was still full of carbs. And so the popcorn it hasn't caused me any adverse reactions, and I really haven't had anything really, really fatty except for like nuts and things like that. The cooking has not been really fatty or what have you, and so I haven't had like the diarrhea or needing to be able to go to the bathroom right away after I eat or anything like that. The other thing about that is I haven't been constipated, which is a good thing. I have added prunes to my diet, and I don't eat them every day, but probably every other day I'll eat two or three prunes. And so I don't know if that's helped me a lot, but I know the popcorn definitely helps me. That popcorn makes me go for certain. That's one thing I do like about it, is because it does help me stay regular, but it's also introducing lots of carbs in my system, and I don't want to be over carbs, and I don't want to be over calories, like crazy from eating that type of food, because that's not what's really adding the good nutrients to my body. So definitely got to get on that. But I have added the prunes, and I don't know if the prunes have helped with the constipation, but I haven't had any Miralax this week, and I haven't had any stool softeners, and I have gone to the bathroom almost every day this week, and it has been normal soft stool. So, yeah. Lovely to talk about stool. Okay, so my breast surgery update. I got my last stitches out on yesterday, and I was a little kind of leery, like there's still some drainage. And so I was asking the surgeon, I said, "Oh, are you sure about taking the stitches out? Is it going to stay together?" And she said, "Yeah." She said at that point it didn't seem like there was any openings. And she even showed me in a mirror, because she'd asked me, "What is that little blister like on your breast along that incision line?" And I said, "I don't know what you're talking about. I hadn't noticed." So she showed me a mirror, and I looked at it, and it did look like a little blister, but everything looked closed up. It didn't look like it was going to drain. I mean, it looked great, like it was about to totally heal. There were two spots that used to drain, one on the top, along that T line incision, and one underneath and along the anchor type incision. That one has totally closed up. There, I don't have to put anything on it. It is totally closed. The one that was on the T line, it was not closed. Like I said, it was still draining, but on yesterday when I went in, when they took out the stitches, it looked like it was totally closed. Well, this morning when I go to change my dressings and I take that dressing off, you could see where it had popped open and left a small incision. So today, after graduation, after hugging and, just enjoying myself and not really thinking about it, because there's not a lot of pain there anymore. There's still some pain, but not a lot. When I get home, I'm thinking, I see a little bit of drainage on my bra. I'm like, oh my goodness. And so I take the dressing off, because I was trying to debate if I should. I try not to manipulate it too much, and so I try to only change the dressing once a day, and instead of like two or three times that I was needing to before or more. So I decided, yeah, I definitely need to change the dressing, because it looked like it was leaking from the bottom and from the top of the little bandage that I put on it. So when I took it off, sure enough, the hole looks bigger. It looks bigger. And not only just that same type of drainage from like the fat necrosis type thing, it was blood. So needless to say, I just took a picture and I'm going to monitor it over the weekend. And I go back to the doctor on Tuesday and I'll go back and just kind of see what she says, because I've been off work a long time, and thank God for short-term disability. So I haven't been just out there just bad, but thank God for short-term disability. But I am anxious to get back to work, and I'm sure they're anxious to get me back because I do hold a key position with my school. Like I said, I'm an assistant principal or assistant school leader, and I need to get back. I need to get back. I need to get back to be able to do my job, but I also know that I need to be completely healed as well to be able to be comfortable in completing my job task. So I'm not going to worry about it. I am, you know, everything else has healed up, so that area has no choice but to fall in line with everything else. I mean, that's just God's order, right? You know, God's order is to heal and to for resolution. And so that's what it's got to fall in line to. It has no choice. No choice. So fall in line. Little hole, just fall in line. So anyway, today my son graduated from high school, and the dress that I had on was, which is not just the total topic, but oh my God, it was so cute. So cute. And when I bought it, the dress size on the tag, I think I threw it away, but the dress size on the tag, I think said a 16. Said a 14 or a 16. And so I just grabbed it up, bought it. May even have said an extra large. Well, today when I was taking it off, y'all, the dress was a large. And I know that there's no way that I would have been able to wear that dress, especially, you know, having gotten rid of the weight, but also having the reduction. That has helped immensely with fitting into things. And I can't wait till my arms kind of come in play with losing the rest of the fat on my arms so that I can fit jackets and things like that a little bit better. But the dress was a large and it was so cute. I'm going to post a picture at the end of my son's graduation and pictures and family. And we just had an excellent time. He had about 20 people come to support him. And if you noticed, and I think I've mentioned this in other videos, if you noticed, I, for the month of April, had the lighted up blue picture at the end of my video. My son has autism, but he is high functioning. He's very intelligent, just independent, and just an amazing artistic kid. And I can't call him a kid anymore. He's an adult. He's 18, but he is just so amazing. And today they did a rose ceremony where they were able to choose 3 roses. And there's only 12 kids in his graduating class, so this is something that they were able to do to fit into their ceremony. Because he goes to a school called Town and Country School. It is the only accredited school in Oklahoma that treats children with multiple disabilities, including Asperger's and different autism. The children have to be at a average intelligence to above average intelligence to be able to attend. They don't really work with children who are lower functioning, you know, on the scale of the autistic spectrum, but they work with high functioning kids that just have a varying disabilities. It could be visual impairment, hearing impairment. It could be, like I said, high functioning autism or Asperger's. It could be dysgraphia. It could be dyslexia. It could be any form sensory issues. They deal with so many kids on so many different levels, but these kids are so bright and so smart and so intelligent. It has just been amazing. The things that they've done for my child. My youngest child attended 1 year. They both attended 1 year, but of course tuition for two children is hard. And so I've really been contemplating, my youngest son just had a hard time this past year, transitioning to the middle school. And so the principal came up to me today. I was telling his old teacher, you know, what a hard time he was having. And she said, oh, I'm going to tell the upper school principal and we're going to try to get him in because they have, you know, so many spots left. And I think they have 7 spots left and we're going to get him in immediately. And so I was thinking to myself, I don't know if the principal want to bother with me again because I've been so out of the loop on different things over this past year. It's just been crazy. But she came right up to me during my son's senior banquet and was like, hey, Miss Meyer, talk to me. I'm going to give you an acceptance letter. Dion hasn't been gone but a couple years, a year or two, and there's no reason that you have to go through all of the different hoops. And I told her, I said, well, no, I really need to apply for a scholarship first before you do that. And she said, it's no problem. She said, I'm going to go ahead and admit him. And I'll send you an acceptance letter through the email and then you can apply for the scholarship and, you know, he'll have his spot. So I'm just going to pray that the scholarship is going to be a full scholarship and just pray that he's able to get what he needs because he needs down in country. He needs a smaller environment. He needs somebody that understands him. He needs somewhere where he can fit in and he needs somewhere where he can operate in the realm that God has put him in. That boy is so smart. He has 122 IQ and there's no reason that this kid should be failing anything. No reason. And there's no reason that he should be feeling bad and have low self-esteem. No reason. And Town and Country is a school that they have the means of being able to build these children's self-esteem. Parent involvement is high. It's just a different type of school, and that is exactly what he needs. So keep that lifted up in prayer. And just as my oldest son transitions from the school into adulthood, you know, he's working on trying to figure out if he's not going to college. He already told me a long time ago that he wasn't going to college. And, you know, college is not for everybody. I loved school. I was one who would have gone to school on Saturdays, Sundays, through the summer. I would have went to school anytime, anywhere. And I have several degrees. I have a chemistry degree. I have a biology pre-med degree. Actually, it's chemistry pre-med. And then I have a biology degree. And then I have an elementary ed degree. I've got my master's in education. I've got my nail tech license. And, you know, I've shared with you guys that recently that I've really wanted to start transitioning back into the science and medical field. So who knows what else is in my future, but I have to understand that that is not my children's future. That is not who they are. That was who I am. And so my oldest son, we're looking at tech and we're looking at some other transitional services for him because he's just anxious to get a job. But I told him, I said, you want to have some type of a skill behind you and it makes you marketable and gives you more options. So we're looking into doing that and he is agreeable to that. But that is about it, y'all. If y'all have any questions, comments, concerns, just comment below. I'm sorry I haven't gotten an opportunity to sit down and respond to the comments from the last video, but I will definitely do it. Y'all know I'm not going to leave y'all hanging, and I've always told you, you know, within a week or two, I would definitely respond to your comments. So I love you guys. I am so thankful for you, and I'm so thankful for this avenue of being able to deliver, you know, my message and my story. So, I didn't tell you guys, finish telling you guys about the rose ceremony. So the rose ceremony, they have an opportunity to pick 3 roses and to give them to those, to 3 people who have been the most influential. So my son immediately brings a rose to me and then he starts looking for the other 2 people that he had planned to give a rose to. I didn't find out until later when I asked him, you know, who were you going to give the other 2 roses to? he said they it was two teachers, but the two teachers weren't there at the graduation. So he came and he gave one to his Mimi, which is my mom. And then somebody had mentioned, your dad's in the back. And I don't think I've ever mentioned this, but I'm divorced. I was together with his father for 13 years, my kid's father with the 13 years. And we divorced and we were amicable for off and on for some time. But for the last year or two or more, we have not spoken at all, hardly. And so Doc went to give his father the rose, and it's just been tough when you're a single mom, when you're divorced, when you're not getting along with the other parent, when the other parent doesn't have an active presence in your children's lives. There's some, he was very active when they were younger, but as they've gotten older, he's kind of fallen off. So anyway, he told Doc, I seen him back there whispering, and I'm telling you, I immediately went negative because I was thinking, what is he telling him? You know, and I thought, you know, cut it out. Just leave it alone. It is fine. So anyway, I turn around and Doc comes up to me and he leans to me and he says, Dad told me to give you the last rose because you deserved more than just the one rose. So immediately I start crying and I'm thinking, that doesn't justify you being an absent parent and not helping me pay tuition and pay medical and pay all this stuff. But it was in my heart and in my mind, I was thinking, okay, thank you. Thank you for acknowledging what I've done, you know, to help these kids grow and to become, you know, the people that they are. So it really made me tear up, made me cry. And I was thankful for that small acknowledgement, you know, even though, you know, I'm thinking it doesn't, but you know what? It was one step forward. So I appreciate that, Doc. I appreciate that, Big Doc. So anyway, thank you guys so much. just keep praying for each other. Keep praying for me. Keep praying for our success. As we go along our journey, you know, we're never going to meet a final destination because we're always going to be either getting rid of the weight or maintaining the weight. So just be ready for that, never gaining the weight back, but getting rid of or maintaining that weight. And I do believe that that's what God has in store for us. So thank you guys so much. I love y'all and I will talk to y'all later. Peace out, babies. Mwah. Love y'all. Whatever it is you came to teach me, I am here to learn it, cause I believe that we are written in the stars. I don't know what the future holds, but I'm living in the moment, and I'm thankful for the man that you are. You are, you are, you are, you are. Everything I asked for in my prayers, so I know my angels brought you to my life. Your energy is healing to my soul. You are a beautiful surprise. You are inspiration to my life.